so hopefully you found out that if we know an eigenvalue, an eigenvector of A, then actually that eigenvector is still an eigenvector of the inverse of this shifted matrix, but the eigenvalue is now replaced by 1 over lambda minus rho. Okay? And similarly, if we know that Ax equals x lambda, then A minus rho times the identity inverse times x is equal to x times the matrix lambda minus the shifted, actually minus the shifted matrix lambda inverse. When we discussed the inverse power method, rho was equal to zero and we just got this and that. Now we merely shift it. So why is this called a shift? Well, this is like shifting the spectrum of matrix A. Every eigenvalue of A is shifted by subtracting out rho. And of course, as a result, if we invert the matrix, then we have to take the reciprocal of that. So why is shifting the matrix a good idea? Well, by shifting the matrix, we shift the spectrum. And by shifting the spectrum, if rho is very close to lambda n minus 1, we can make this ratio very, very large, especially large relative to this next ratio. Okay, so what does this suggest? This suggests that if we have a good idea of what the smallest eigenvalue is associated with a matrix, then we can instead iterate with the shifted matrix inverse. Okay. We obviously, in our analysis, then would want to multiply by this right here. In practice, we would do what we always do, which is keep our vector of length 1 at every step by normalizing it. And what does that mean up here? That means up here that we need to subtract off rho times I, and then we would invert that. Okay? And then we would multiply that here by, let's see, lambda m minus 1 minus rho to the kth power, if this is the version that we're analyzing. Then this ratio would still be 1, but this one right here would be replaced by minus rho in the numerator and the denominator to the kth power times x m minus 2, and then the rest of them. And right here, each of these would be replaced by minus rho, minus rho, minus rho. And the important thing here is, if rho is very close to lambda m minus 1, then this ratio here becomes much more favorable. And therefore, we expect to get to our result much faster. And that's the shifted inverse power method.